to share. Thank you for sharing things that you bring and all of that good stuff. I'm doing all the housekeeping announcements, so if you have a glass, would you mind please keeping it all evening, and then when you're done, just bring it to the kitchen and we'll take it?
Yes.
If you have a cell phone, please take pictures and post them and tag them and do all of that wonderful stuff, but
okay,
without flash and without sound. If you have sound, you can turn that all off right now. That would be great. And if you need to leave, there is an exit over here, and that is the exit. If there is an emergency, we have a second one over here that, if you guys don't mind, you're a charger back there. Keep nice and clear and open it up, but only in an emergency. And if you need to use a restroom, there's one on every floor on the left-hand side of the room. And I think that's it. We have a donation jar, if anybody's so inclined. And Benoit is going to tell you about everything else, so smile, please.
Yes.
Thank
you. Thank you.
I have to tell her to remind her to be careful, because otherwise you... All right, so just a couple of things. Like, we've been doing this for almost 18 years now. Yes, Pat is our, let's see, 722nd concert, I believe. Usually we have an artist working live, but you know, we said, you know, Pat deserves the whole stage to himself. But we do have two pieces there. They're lit up, and that's because artists over the year, they've given us art for us to sell because they want to donate to the foundation. And so you can buy these. Like, talk to Chris, and he'll set you up. And we have many more. If both these go, we have more that I could show. I just want to show a couple at a time. No need to take all of them out every time. So we have concerts every Sunday, pretty much. This Sunday is a saxophone quartet, the Rova saxophone quartet, avant-garde kind of stuff. They've been playing together for 40 years, so that's pretty cool. They're out from the San Francisco area. And then next week is Alterity Chamber Orchestra, not here on Thursday. It's at the ballet rehearsal hall or building. See that? See? Good timing. Perfect. Get that over now. Yeah. All right. So, but the most important thing for us, that the easiest way to help us and maybe help yourself, is get a membership. And there's several levels of memberships, and you can, you know, sponsor a visual artist. You can sponsor a musician, a concert. You can sponsor, you know, at different levels. You can get an ad up there for a whole year. Talk to Chris about that. He's our executive director. Chris is, where is Chris? He's the good-looking one. So talk to the good-looking man in the organization. There's Chris. Chris Belt, everybody. Yeah. Yeah, he's the person you want to talk to about memberships and everything else. Like, he's the one you want to give your money to, right? Not me, him, you know? Anyways, so that's it for me. We have, of course, a very special treat tonight. You know that because you came. And so, you know, make sure you get on the email list if you're new here. You don't know what's coming up and stuff. You know, we'll send you one email per week, and you'll know exactly what's going on. And, you know, members get a special email with special information, member-only events. We try to very hard to make our members happy, and I think we're doing a decent job. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right. So, are you ready for some music? Please help me welcome Pat Donohue.
I don't tune anyway. Thank you.
favorite guitar players of all time, Blind Blake. He was from Jacksonville, Florida, and I'm sure the West Coast he was talking about is, well, the West Coast of Florida. I feel certain of it. He was one of those blind street singers you hear about now and then that he made his way to Chicago in the late 20s, a great guitar player in ragtime blues style. He was one of the inventors of. Anyway, he became a star on the blues label, and then the Depression came along. From which he never recovered. So I'm trying not to follow his career path as closely as his guitar licks. I guess they buried him in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Can you imagine? From Jacksonville, Florida, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It's anybody's intention to be buried there. Folks. Hey, thanks for coming out tonight. Pat Donohue from St. Paul, Minnesota. Yes. Florida is full of Minnesotans. I wonder why. Minnesota, the land of 10,000 lakes and one really nice day. That's the way it is there. Southland in many a song and rhyme, and I guess I'd do well to visit the Delta someday if I get the time. But in the land of sky blue waters, she loved me, then she turned me loose with the other end of the Mississippi River blues. You got the blues down in Louisiana. Sing them up in Memphis, child, where the muddy waters flows, and everybody knows it's the cradle of that mournful sound. But somewhere up near Lake Itasca, where the mighty river starts to ooze, yeah, I got the other end of the Mississippi River blue. They got the honeysuckle vine, I got the lonesome pine. They got banjos on the levee, I got a frozen over Chevy. Well, it all ends up in New Orleans, but this is where it all begins. You can travel the wide world over anywhere you care to roam, but if you ever go to Northern Minnesota, better leave your heart at home. she'll love you, then she'll leave you crying with a feeling that you can't shake loose. And that's the other end of the Mississippi River. Let's see, what should I play now? There's all the good ones, but I don't know, I'll try this. Thank you. Thank you, folks. I hope you like that. I put that in the set to make sure that the material is up to par in some way. All right. Well, let's see. It's been a long winter in Minnesota. And this is a song about that. I'm going to catch me a groove, if you don't mind. This morning, not looking great. My baby told me to lose some weight. She said, I love ya, I think you're sweet, but when I hug ya, my hands don't meet. I said, darling, don't you realize I get the blues when I exercise? Yes, I feel it, huh? I'm out of breath. My heart is beating, I'm close to death. I try to hustle, but it's a strain. Ain't got a muscle that's not in pain. It's times like this I realize I get the blues when I exercise. Yes, I do. Treading on the mill and get to sweating and lose my will. I start to pumping on the bike. I know there's something that I don't like. I like those burgers and biggie fries. I get the blues when I exercise. Yes, I do. She got me running. She got me biking. She got me running, biking, jogging, hiking. Everywhere I go, and I let it roll. I said, yeah, yeah, yeah. I guess I'm just one of those guys. I get the blues when I exercise. Yes, I do. I've been in bar bands before. I know how to do that. Some of me gone. I'm gonna wheeze and touch my toes till I can squeeze back in my clothes, or maybe just buy a larger size. I get the blues when I exercise. Yes, I do. Duke Ellington, he's the composer of this next piece. Duke Ellington, of course, we all heard of him, but we don't know that his real name, back in whenever he was born in the 18-somethings, his name was Edward Kennedy Ellington. I always thought that was funny. so he really needed a nickname, even back in those days. Thank you.
play you a little song about my life in the music business. Maybe yours, I don't know. Any guitar players out there? A couple of guitar players. Somebody who takes $5,000 worth of equipment in a $500 car 100 miles to a $50 gig. Would you like to play the guitar? Take your money home in a jar and pretend that you're a big star. Or would you rather get a job? Oh, well, a job is the thing that makes you get out of bed and work every day until you're dead. Your back is aching and your brain is numb, and you just can't wait until the weekends come. But if you don't want to starve or beg or rob, you just might have to get a job. Or would you like to play the guitar? Drive for miles and miles in your car and pretend that you're a big star. Or would you rather book the gig? Well, the agent's the one who's gonna get his percent. What he said ain't exactly what he meant. He'll clean you out in ways you never thought, 'cause he's good at business and he knows you're not. And then he'll sue if you finally make it big, 'cause he's the guy that booked the gig. Oh, but would you like to play the guitar for a living, hardy har har? I admit it's a kind of bizarre, but would you rather be the wife? Well, the wife is the one who has to rescue our butts. She's either a saint or else she's nuts. She gets impatient and she gets annoyed, 'cause she's the one who must remain employed. And by the way, if you want to wreck your life, become a guitar player's wife. 'Cause all the monkeys aren't in the zoo, they can be trained to play guitar too. Some do a whole lot better than you, but even if you don't go far, you could be worse off than you are. At least you're playing your guitar. Thank you. I appreciate it. This is my Floridist shirt. Yep. My Floridist shirt, and it was given to me by a good friend and agent, Louise Baker, who is not here tonight, but she'd be glad to know I was wearing it. If you'd like to join me on one, please don't sing. I should have said that at the beginning of the show, but if you can snap your fingers, though, I could use some help on this one, because this is one of the few songs you're going to hear tonight about golf. And golf, I won't even ask golfers to identify themselves, but it's a game that I tried to play when I was younger and didn't have the temperament for it. And this song, like a lot of my songs, it's not exactly a true story, I can't say, but it's not exactly not. So I'll just say that. But what your part in this would be, should you choose to accept it, is to snap, but on the offbeat. So we have to rehearse it once it goes. Like that. And it happens every now and then in the song, but you don't want to keep doing it throughout the song. Yes, many people found that out the hard way. It involved ambulances and rehab and all kinds of things, because your hand will cramp up. So just a few times, you'll know when it is. Like right now, we'll start. Ready? One, two, three, four. Perfect. Voila, some people say golf is a game to relax. I used to be one of those weekend hacks. You chase a little white ball into a little round hole. It'll addle your mind and steal your soul. You play 18 holes, and what do you get? Greater frustration and deeper regret. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause Lord above, I owe my soul to the country club. Ready? Mm-hmm. Well, I was born one morning in the bright sunshine. I picked up my clubs and I played the front nine. I learned how to swear on the number nine hole, and the club pro said, kid, out you go. You lay 18 holes, what do you get? Greater frustration and deeper regret. Well, St. Peter, don't you call me, cause the Lord above, I owe my soul to the country club. Well, I spent one season on the PGA, but I lost my temper and they turned me away. I got so mad on the 18th green, I busted my putter on the Coke machine. So if you see me coming, better let me play through, cause I got a mean slice and I might be new. I got a mind that's weak, a swing that's, a mouth that's bouncy, a swing that's bad, a mouth that's foul and pants that's plaid. You play 18 holes and what do you get? Greater frustration and deeper regret. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause Lord above, I owe my soul to the country club. Mm-hmm. Take it, Pat. Okay, I don't mind if I do. Some people say a man was born to retire, sell off the business and move to Fort Myers, spend all year long in the blazing sun for just one more shot at a hole in one. But I'll stay back home on the northern plains, where the winter brings snow and the summer brings rain. I gotta do something, but it won't be golf, cause there's something about it just pisses me off. You play 18 holes, and what do you get? Greater frustration and deeper regret. Oh, St. Peter, make arrangements with Beelzebub. I owe my soul to the country club. Thank you, folks. Well, I think every folk singer ought to have a road song of some sort. Spent a lot of time on the road, so this will be mine. I made it up years ago, and I don't know, it just sort of fell out one day, but I've been a-picking it ever since. Something about who was right and who was wrong. Nobody cared who won. We all had our fun out on the road to kingdom come. On up along the rise, they're selling truth and lies. Whatever the buyer buys, the truth becomes. Till it don't matter. None, it's look out for number one out on the road to kingdom come. Out on the highway side, over the great divide, knowing the end this night has just begun. It's such a lonesome drive, how can a soul survive out on the road to kingdom come? I saw a love so great, I saw the strongest hate, I felt the awful weight of choosing one. I saw hope and despair playing true for dare out on the road to kingdom come. There's no highway sign, there's no light to shine. You can lose your mind if you have one, you better hope and pray and you can find your way out on the road. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, man. You having a good time?
Yeah.
That's cool. I hate to be the only one. Baby, please don't go the way I love you. You'll never know. So come back, baby. Let's talk it over one more time. I will admit that I was wrong. 'Cause little girl, you've been gone way too long. So come back, baby. Let's talk it over one more time. If I could holler like a mountain jack, I'd go up on the mountain and call my baby back. Oh, come back, baby. Let's talk it over one more time. I feel the need to talk it over. Chet Atkins fans out there tonight? Have to be. Chet Atkins was a great guitar player, of course, and also a great guy, and I was happy to get a chance to meet him and play with him a bit, because he was, when I first started playing on A Prairie Home Companion radio show, he was still a frequent guest, and so we got to play together several occasions, and one time we played together a song on the air. Maybe I'll play that for you later, but I thought, well, this is a huge thrill. How am I going to make this happen again? And I wrote up a song about Chet Atkins, and then he kind of had to do it with me. But he was nice enough, too. And so I'll play that for you now. Chet, who almost never used the capo, but he didn't sing. With a little record player sitting on the basement shelf. I got my guitar out and there's some licks I'm on again. I'm sitting in the basement, stealing from Chet. It ain't easy for a boy from way up north to try and make his thumb go back and forth. It's enough to sometimes make me get upset, just sitting in the basement, stealing from Chet. 'Cause I don't wanna be a country star. No, I just wanna do that thing that he does on guitar. And I'm hoping if I practice by the hour, someday I could pick that wildwood flower. But I've often found it worth the toil and the sweat, just sitting in the basement, stealing from Chet. Stuff like this. Like that. this year. Every guitar player's got to have this one. I don't know, I might have made that one up myself there. When I first heard him play, it was a whole new world. Maybe like when he first heard old Merle. Yeah, but Travis picked it up from somewhere, you can bet. So I'm sitting in the basement, I'm stealing from Chet. He told me once he used to think he was a real good player. And by the time he found out he was wrong, he was too rich to care. Well, I've never heard the picker that can top him yet. So I'm sitting in the basement, I'm stealing from Chet. One time, I remember, and I thought he was just joking at the time. He said, we were playing something together. He said, if you make a mistake, I don't know why he said that to me at that moment, but anyway, he said, if you make a mistake, do it twice. That way they think you meant it. Hardy har har, but you know, I've been using that since this song started, for sure. Sometimes I go looking for the bad notes, you know, like that. Yeah, there's no bad notes, just bad people with notes. It's gonna be fun another one. Yeah, there's a. That's a bad note. You get the point. Oh, too sweet, right? Tangy, but not quite. Right? Not quite, that's tough. There it is. Yeah, I meant to do that. Well, it doesn't matter if you're young or old, if you play country, folk, or rock and roll. Heavy guitar, picker, rolls, that man a debt. All been there before, making our fingers sore, just filching every note that we could get. Yeah, sitting in the basement, stealing from Chet. Donohue on stage here. I'm going to try and medleyize three little numbers that have never been medleyized before. I don't think. the Irish Segway. This is a piece I wrote with my good friend James Joyce. He doesn't know it, so it's just as well. And he wrote a story one time called The Dead. And this is about the last paragraph of it. Yes, the newspapers were right. Snow was general all over Ireland. It was falling on every part of the dark central plain. On the treeless hills, falling softly upon the bog of Allen, and farther westward, softly falling into the dark, mutinous Shannon waves. Part of that lonely churchyard on the hill where Michael Fury lay buried. On the treeless hills, falling softly upon the bog of Allen, and farther westward, softly falling into the dark, mutinous Shannon waves. Like the descent of your last end upon all the living and the dead. Patty Donohue from St. Paul, Minnesota, but we get the blues too. Well, I woke up this morning and got out of bed, and my face was all ruddy, my hair was all red, and my eyes were all bloodshot. I thought I was dead. Woke up today with the Irish blues. Well, I try to be good, but faith and begorra, I go to bed laughing and wake up in sorrow and muddle. You bet it's the same thing tomorrow. I woke up today with the Irish blues. We really got going, and last night the Guinness was flowing, the singing, the dancing, I couldn't refuse. I woke up today with the Irish blues. Just like my daddy, I like to go out on the feast of St. Paddy and take on the ways of a much younger laddie and wake the next day with the Irish blues. Cause my brother's a priest and my sister's a nun and my wife is against any measure of fun, so I go out myself and I get the job done and I wake the next day with the Irish blues. And last night we really got going, and last night the Guinness was flowing, the singing, the dancing, I couldn't refuse. I woke up today with the Irish blues. Seamus and Katie were lying in the bed one night, and Katie felt Seamus's hand on her neck. Oddly enough, down to her shoulders, down her back, and further, and even further, and then it started back up again. And then he stopped, and she said, "Seamus, why did you stop?" He said, "I found the remote control." Well, I get up early because Masses is seven, and there I find Seamus and Michael and Kevin. We're all trying to get our sad souls into heaven. We woke up today with the Irish blues. And last night we really got going, and last night the Guinness was flowing, the swing and the dance, and I couldn't refuse. I woke up today with the Irish blues. Yeah. Thank you for that. Thank you. I don't know what was up with that ending there, but you just never know. And, I don't even take a set list with me on stage anymore, because I used to and spent a lot of time creating it, and then I would deviate from it and then get all mixed up and go back to one song that I already did because I was trying to make up. Yeah, I got rid of it. And now we'll just all find out what the next song is together. That's how it is now. But you never know. But thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, where am I? What was that? Here's one of my... I feel bad about it, but it's just the way it is. I don't know. What goes up must come down. What goes around comes around. And when it comes around to me, that's when I'm all alone. But it's too late and it's too bad. I used to think the days back then. I used to dream how they could be that way again. But those dreams are undone. 'Cause it's too late and it's too bad. She's too gone. Yes, she's gone without a trace. And I know I am to blame. If again I see her face, she could never feel the same. If I was less like I am, more like I could be, I would still have her love. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, very much. This place, I really like this place. Are you looking for a house band? I love this place, and thank you for having me here. It's really one of the nicest sounding things I've ever played. Even if it's me, this is really good sound. It might not sound that way to you, but it is. Anyway, thanks very much. This one. This cause I was motivating over the hill. Saw Maybelline in a Cooperville, Cadillac moving on the open road, and nothing, I'd run my V8 for a Cadillac doing about 95, wheels bumper to bumper and side to side. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You don't start back doing them things you used to do. Stuff like that. Wouldn't do no more. Then it got cloudy and it started raining. I turned my horn for the passing lane. Rainwater blowing all under my hood. I knew that was doing my motor good. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Ooh, Maybelline, why can't you be true? You don't start back doing them things you used to do. Well, Maybelline. Sitting like a tunnel lid, 110 half mile ahead. Cadillac looking like a sitting still, and I called Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline, why can't you be true? Oh, Maybelline, you don't start back doing them things you used to do. Thank you, folks.
Thank you so much again for having me and for even having me for one more. That's good. What will that be? I can't wait to find out what it's going to be myself. I know, maybe I'll just play a little opera music to end up the night, because I know that's what you really want. no, the, the secret to good opera is you just get rid of all that singing. Okay? Then you're left with things like that. Small dog in Italian. Thank you so much, folks. Good night. That's extremely kind. Thank you. I'll play you this one here and finish off with this great, I won't say great, but the song is, it's The Great Freight Train by the great Elizabeth Cotton. And the way you finger pick, folks, it's just a parlor trick. You just get your thumb going like this. See that? And then, you know, only trick is then if you want to play. You have to do it just at the right time. You know, like you have to. Right, yeah, that's the hard part, but it's easier because there's only two ways to do it. There's it's right on the beat. Which is kind of correct, but not really. It's the first time, it's right, not really. But the only other way to do it is to play the melody in between these beats. Like, between now and a couple of seconds from now, I'm going to be really sick of that, too. For somehow, these are the zeros and ones of finger picking, and I'll try and put them together for you here. That's it now. Get the heck out of here. Thank you so much.